Lord, I thank you for this word. I thank you for this day. I thank you for giving us life, oh God, another day, covering us under your blood. Father, we know it's not by might nor by power, but by your spirit. And greater is he that is in us than he that is in the world. I thank you, God, that we are the head, we are not the tail. We're above and we are not beneath. Father, you cause our feet to be in an even place. Father, you'll not cause us to slip. You'll cause us not to fall. You says, God, if we seek you, everything else shall be added unto us, Lord. So we just want to give you the praise. We just want to give you the glory and the honor, Lord. Thank you for who you are. Thank you for your sovereignty. Thank you for you being God. Thank you that you are a king. You are Lord of lords and King of kings. Father, we're looking to you from whence comes our help, Lord. We lift up our eyes unto the hills from whence comes our help, O God. You are our shepherd. We shall not want. We are blessed, O God, if we walk not in the counsel of the ungodly. We thank you, Jesus, that we can dwell in your secret place. So, God, I thank you right now in the name of Jesus. Guys, the word that I'm hearing from the Lord today is that your struggles and your trial is not in vain. Your struggles and your trials, they are not in vain. God is saying your struggles and trials are not in vain. One of the things that he wants you all to know is the things that you go through, the worse your trials, the worse your struggles, the worse things that you encounter, the greater level in which he's going to be able to use you, the higher your anointing, the higher is the call on your life. The higher is a call on your life, the greater your struggles, the greater your persecutions, the greater things that you go through, the things that you're facing in your life, the higher is your call and the higher is the anointing that is on your life. The stronger is the anointing that is on your life. God wants you to know that he's been with you and he is with you through each and every one of your trials. He is not blind. And he's not deaf to the things that you are encountering and what you're going through. But what the Lord needs you to do during this time is to trust him. To trust him with all your heart. Not lean onto your own understanding, but in all your ways acknowledge him and he shall direct your path. Those of you say, why was I born into this family? Why did this happen to me? Why did I end up having this surgery? Why did I end up getting sick? God is saying all things work together for the good for them that loves him, those that are the called according to his purpose. And God is saying there is divine purpose in everything that you have encountered and everything that you're going through. But what matters is how you deal with it while you go through it. Are you going to curse God and die? Or are you going to dig deeper into the things of God and trust him to take you through to the other side? God is saying there's nothing that you're going through that is a surprise to him and that is punishment upon you. Some of you are starting to doubt and say, maybe God is punishing me. Maybe God hates me. Maybe God does not want me. But God is saying you're simply being tried and proved and refined for the greater purpose that I have for you. The Lord wants you to remember what Jesus went through when he was on this earth. Technically, he was born to die. That's what happened. He was born to die. He was born. He went through a lot of rejection. He went through a lot of abuse in his life, being scorned and ultimately crucified. But he had purpose. He was the Son of God. He was a son of God, yet the way he lived and the things that he went through would tell you otherwise, would make you think otherwise. You are my sons. You are my daughters. That is what the Lord is saying. Don't find it surprising when you go through things, when you go through dark trials and tribulations. But what matters the most is how you handle things while you're going through it. I've given you the Holy Spirit to give you the strength that you would no otherwise have as a in your flesh, as a human. I've given you everything that you need to be able to stand, to be able to persevere. There is nothing that you go through that is just because. So God is saying there is a divine purpose, a divine call, a reason for everything that you are experiencing. Learn to trust me. That is what I hear God saying. Learn to trust me. Seek me out in my word. Seek me out by reaching out to me for counsel, and I will show you the things that you shall do. I will show you things that you have never known or ever seen. If you keep looking in the natural, you will be discouraged. So you need need to look in the Spirit. You're not going to be able to look in the Spirit without my Holy Spirit. And you need to trust me. You need to set your sights on me, set your minds on me, so that you're able to go through this trial, come out on the other side, refined, sharp, and ready, so that you can help others who are lost, who are where you've been. God says everything is all for his purpose. Be still, trust, seek me, do not doubt me. I have a purpose in everything that you experience in your life. God, we thank you for your words. We thank you, God, that we're trusting you no matter what, that we're not leaning onto our own understanding. Father, revive my brothers and sisters. Give them strength. Those, God, who's afraid, even the unsaved, oh God, I pray that you'll touch them right now in the name of Jesus, that they'll not feel that they've been thrown away and they don't have a purpose and they are meant to go through evil things. God, the devil is a liar. So Lord, we thank you that they're learning your truth. They're seeing your truth. God, we just give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. We give you all the praise. And we want to say thank you right now in Jesus' name. Amen. Don't you dare let go. Keep on moving.